In this chapter, we look at the chimp's effect processor. We show you how effects are built up and which parameters we can configure. Thank you for your interest in the Infinity Chimp Light Controller, and welcome to this tutorial. To learn more about the various parts of the Infinity Chimp Light Controller keyboard and screen, you are advised to watch Tutorial 1 and 2, Hardware and Software. This tutorial is based on software version 1.3. If your chimp uses a different software version, the functions or user interface may be different. Please note that we refer to the chimp hardware keys as keys and the GUI software keys as buttons in this tutorial. Create effect. The effects can be found in the second attributes menu in the programmer. If we press the 1/2 button, we see the effects button. There is also an effects key on the chimp keyboard, which we can use to access the menu. This function is always available and always displays the effects screen. In the effects split widget, we see add effects, which is used to add an effect, and delete effects, which is used to delete an effect. There are also a number of off effect functions, which we will discuss later. To add an effect, we first select the fixtures that we want to program. In our case, we select the performers using the front group. We then tap on Add Effects and see some of the possibilities of the effect processor. In the upper toolbar, we can see Predefined Effects and Custom Effect. Predefined effects are the effects that are pre-programmed. Custom effect can be used to program our own effects. Under the Custom Effect button, we see the attributes to which we can apply effects. Since we have chosen the performers as a fixture, we can only choose the dimmer attribute. We will therefore choose a fixture with more attributes. We now select the group of IS400 fixtures. For these fixtures, we pre-programmed a preset in our example that configures the dimmer, color, and position, and tap on Add Effects in the Effects Split widget. We now see that these fixtures have far more effect options. This applies to both the predefined effects and the custom effect. If we select Custom Effect, we can choose from all our attributes to create our own effect. Effect Parameters. We will now look at the predefined effects and explain the parameters. In our example, we select the tilt sign effect by tapping on the button. We see that the selected fixtures perform the effect. The effect is also visible in the output visualizer on the chimp screen. In the split widget for the effects, we see the tilt sign effect line. In addition to the effect, there are several other parameters that can influence the effect. First of all, we see sign under type and can select it by tapping on it. If we want to change it, we press the set key. We can see various shapes we can use to perform the effect. In our example, we leave the sign as it is and tap on the cancel button to go back again. Next to type, you can see fixtures, which shows the number of fixtures carrying out the effect, 8 in our case. If we want to change this number, we tap on 8 and press the set key. The pop-up menu contains the following possibilities. If we choose Replace Programmer Selection by Fixtures, then only those fixtures that use this effect are selected, and all other fixtures are deselected. If we choose the Merge FX fixtures into Programmer Selection, then all the selected fixtures are added to the existing selection. If we choose Store Selected Fixtures into Effect, then only the selected fixtures are included in the effect. At the moment, we do not want to make any changes to these settings, and therefore tap on the Cancel button. We then see the following four options: Size, Speed, Offset, and Duty Cycle. These are also displayed on the labels on the bottom toolbar. These labels are assigned to the four rotary encoders. In our example, we will change the size by turning Rotary Encoder 1. We can see that the size of the tilt effect changes. We can change the speed of the effect by turning Rotary Encoder 2, or by pressing it. A pop-up menu now appears. Here, we can enter a value. The pop-up menu shows a number of ways in which we can change the speed. In this tutorial, we will discuss the most common method, using the keypad and speed presets. In our example, we choose a pre-programmed value. We choose 25 CPM by tapping on it. The next function is the offset. We can change this value in a number of different ways: by rotating Rotary Encoder 3, by pressing the encoder, or by tapping the button on the screen. A pop-up menu appears again. We now choose the value range 0 through 90. The offset makes it possible to distribute the effect across the selected fixtures with a proportionate number of degrees. We can also change the offset values by selecting them and pressing the Set key. The Randomize Range function is turned on by tapping on the Randomize Range button. This function ensures that the offset sequence is determined randomly. We turn it off by tapping on the Randomize Range button, followed by the Range 0 through 90 button. The next parameter is the Duty Cycle. In our example, we set it to 66%. We now see that the current effect stops for a third of the time and continues for two-thirds of the time. The bottom toolbar contains even more options to change the effect. We scroll to the right to make the grouping, buddying, wings, and direction functions visible. We change the grouping by tapping the current value and then pressing the Set key. We'll create some groups. If we press 4, the group size is 4. In our case, two groups of four fixtures. To delete this setting, we press the Set key and then tap on the Off button. Next to the grouping parameter is the buddying function. We change the buddying by tapping the current value and then pressing the Set key. We now enter 2 and confirm with the Enter button. We can see that the fixtures are now linked to one another and behave in the same way, as though they have the same address. We also switch off this function in our example. Next to buddying is the wings parameter. We activate wings by tapping the current value and then pressing the Set key. We now enter 2 and confirm the Enter button. We can see that the effect is divided into two wings. This produces two groups that are played as a mirror image. Combining effects. The chimp can play several effects at the same time. We press Add Effects to make this happen. We scroll down and select the dimmer wave effect. we see that both effects have been selected. To only change the dimmer wave effect using the encoders, we first deselect the tilt effect by tapping on it. We can now use encoder 1 to change the size. We set it to 200%. The effect increases by 100% and decreases by 100% in relation to the reconfigured value of this attribute, which in our case is the dimmer. Next to the size function is the speed function, which we'll also change. We select 25 for the speed so that the speeds are the same. Recording effects. We can save the effect we have created in a queue. We do this by pressing the record key followed by an empty fader label on the screen. In our case, we choose fader label 10. We'll call the queue effects. We have now saved the effect and will clear the programmer by pressing the clear key for 2 seconds. To activate the effect, we slide fader 10 upwards and can see that the effect is activated. Operating effects in playback. The fader and keys relating to the cue containing the recorded effect can be given various functions. We do this by pressing the edit key followed by fader label 10. We can see which functions have been assigned to the keys and fader. We can change the function of the fader by tapping on the function assigned to it. In our case, dimmer, which opens up a drop-down menu. In this menu, we choose the effect size function. The fader has now been given the function to change the size of the effect, and then tap on the close button. We now open the cue list. We press the open key, followed, in our case, by the fader label 10 button. We can see the cue list on the right-hand side of our screen. By tapping on the settings button, we enter a menu which contains a summary of more settings for this cue list. We want our effect to be influenced by FX Speed Master 1, which we choose in the Effects Speed Master drop-down menu. We now have the size of the effect on Fader 10 and the speed on the effect on FX Speed Master 2. Off effects. The off effects command is used to exclude certain fixtures within the effect. In order to place a drummer in the spotlight, we have created a drummer preset. This gives fixtures 404 and 405 a different programming. If we select these, we see that the color and position change, but that the effect still continues. We can switch off this effect in the effect processor with off intensity and off position. We see that the two selected fixtures, 404 and 405, are ignored by the effect. We can save this by pressing the record key, followed by fader label 10. We want to add a new cue in the cue list, and therefore choose the option Append as New Cue and call the new cue Drum. We then press the clear key to empty the programmer and select the fixtures 404 and 405 once again. For the next cue, we want to undo the drum effect on fixtures 404 and 405. To program this cue, we use the playback of the effect to load the programmer. We first select fixtures 404 and 405 once again. we press the infinity key. Keep it pressed, and then press the load key. The programmer is now loaded with the values of Q1 on fixtures 404 and 405. We save these values in a new queue by pressing the record key, followed by fader label 10. We give this queue a name, in our case, FX. We press the clear key for 2 seconds again to empty the programmer and deselect everything. We have now saved 3 cues under fader label 10. Step 1 is the total effect on all fixtures. By pressing the corresponding playback key, we can go to Q2. We see that the 2 fixtures are ignored in the effect and that they go to the position that we programmed. In Q3, the fixtures are included in the effect again. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Infinity strives to keep its chimp-related tutorials and software information up to date. Keep an eye on our social media channels for the latest information on the chimp.